talks a narrow defeat for the team in the end, but you made Australia sweat there to get over the finish line. So there's lots of positives we can take from that performance.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, Ian Bell's innings, for one thing, really set us up at the top of the order. Showed his experience and class again, and shows where he's at personally, which is, he's setting his standards really high for early, so early in the tour. And again, we based our innings around him and tried to set it up for the last 10, but Australia bowled a pretty good last 10 overs. So the first 40 were pretty good, and the skill level was pretty high. But I've not seen Australia bowl like that in the last 10 overs for a long time.
Do you think on that wicket, 300 was a par score? Would you say so?
Yeah, I think 300 was a par score. Obviously, we had higher expectations to get 340 plus. And I think if we had found a way to negotiate the swing bowling and the variations that they had, we might have got closer.
Just a word on Belly again. You know, he seems to be in the form of his life. You know, what's the difference with him on this tour? Have you noticed any adjustments in his game or anything that he's doing differently?
No particular adjustments. He looks confident and he looks at ease with himself, which is great to see, because I think that brings the best out of him.
And just on the bowling display, we kept going. Chris Wokes was fantastic at the death. Do you take a lot of confidence from the way we've been bowling? And there's a lot of different players that are chipping in with wickets as well.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, to take it that deep in the innings, the guys did really well, given that we only got up to a par score. So credit to the guys on that behalf. I mean, it would have taken something very special for us to get across the line, but it wasn't meant to be. We got the ball reverse swinging for a little bit of a period, but not for long enough, and Australia managed to fight their way through that.
We have a bit of a break now in Perth before the next game a week on Friday against India. What did the guys do now? Did they take a bit of a break and reflect on the tri series and then go again, I suppose?
Yeah, the guys will be fresh again for the game against India. We'll have a couple of days off and then hit the ground running when we get to Perth. So again, I think it's important to go into the games mentally and physically fresh, in order to get the best out of ourselves.